goal was to do a little, a residency that was more art for the sake of art. All of our previous residencies primarily incorporated the art form into a curriculum, such as science, nature, that sort of thing. And in this one, we wanted to incorporate it into art, the music, drama, theater, dance, and see what we could create with that.
The Artist in Residency program is a collaboration between our art teacher, Mrs. Huar, and Mr. Wacker and Arts Path here at IUP to bring in professional artists to the elementary school to work with our elementary students, to teach them, to guide them, to create collaborative works of art.
We have had the opportunity to have different artists come to our school and work with K through 6th, which is what our school is. And they bring such a wonderful passion to the program. And it just enhances what I do and what our school district does.
We start off with a piece of wood, and it's rectangular, but it's a rectangular prism. And I always ask them, what shape this is? And then I turn it down to the next shape, and then I ask them what it is, and they say a cylinder. So they are trying to connect what they know from school and something real. So then it's a cylinder, and then we shape it into basically a pen. We put some lines in it with a skew. It drives a little metal into the wood, and then we burn it with a wire, a nichrome wire, and that burns it in. And I always ask them, so what's it doing now? And they say, it's burning it. And I say, well, why is it burning it? And they say, it's burning it because it's friction. And it's amazing how even the first grader will know this, you know, and then they all pick up on it.
Then we had Martha Murphy, who is a mixed media artist who has been at our school, I believe, 2 or 3 times now. Martha worked in many different things with the kids. She worked with metal. She worked with the wood, also collaborated with Linda. And also we had John Kirk, who was a photographer. He came and he documented the entire residency. And to work with 3 very passionate artists and to have so many different people with creative ideas, and we all work together to make it happen, is, I think, extraordinary.
We were able to educate the kids in a way that they probably didn't understand until after the fact, that they started to understand about line and form and relate that to music and their visual arts, also their writing skills. And so we're teaching them without them really understanding what we're pushing them into. And they're able to understand that repeating patterns and rhythm is everywhere, that everything that they're looking at is a visual impact, and that their own visual impact became part of the community in Clarion, the coffee house. When I got to see pictures of the exhibit, I was astounded, really, myself, because you don't see it as a full grouping. To look at the quality of the work that we did with these elementary kids, I don't think I've seen the likes of it.